Now, speaking of the weather, we're going to get a little bit more on your all-important Christmas forecast now.
Angus Hines joins us live from the Weather Bureau. Angus, good morning to you. Now, it won't be the sunny summer Christmas many were hoping for this year.
Good morning and Merry Christmas. No, unfortunately not a perfect day for everyone. In particular, really, we're tracking the risk of thunderstorms and maybe even some severe thunderstorms across eastern parts of the country, from about central Queensland all the way down to Victoria. And unfortunately, yes, that does include those big centres, Brisbane, Sydney, Newcastle, Wollongong, maybe even Melbourne, lining up for some showers and possible thunderstorms on Christmas Day. So, of course, it is a time for relaxation and celebration, but still worth keeping half an eye on the forecast and half an eye on the weather warnings, particularly around those eastern states, because we could see some pretty big thunderstorms, which can bring damaging wind, can bring really heavy rainfall, which leads to flooding, can even bring some large hail through some of those eastern areas, likely through Christmas afternoon and evening.
So Angus, when we look at that map there, you can see it really looks like the entire east coast of the country is going to get a proper soaking, including those really severe storms. What are causing these conditions at the moment in late December?
Yeah, well, there's a couple of contributing factors at the moment. Firstly, we've got a tongue of very warm water off eastern parts of the country, particularly the New South Wales and southern Queensland coast. And that means when we get an onshore wind flow, which we have at the moment, the warm water promotes evaporation. So we get these warm, humid, sticky conditions. And lots of people will have felt that over the past week or so. It's been really humid, even outside of those thunderstorm times. And that warmth, that humidity, that's sort of the fuel that feeds these thunderstorms. Then you get a bit of support from the upper atmosphere, gets a little bit of vertical motion going, and all of a sudden these storms can kick off. So it is, we really do have all the ingredients in the recipe for severe thunderstorms for eastern parts of the country over the next couple of days.
No. All right. Well, I just want to let the kids know that there's two epic reindeer on board, Donna Blitzen. That translates to thunder lightning. Awesome navigators around storms. They love it. They'll bring Santa on home. So once the storm's clear, we want to know, when is it going to warm up in the east?
Yeah, it does take a little while. That stormy risk, that stormy chance for much of eastern Australia continues into Boxing Day on the 26th. But from the day after that, Wednesday onwards, we see a pretty significant clearing of that that risk of severe weather and thunderstorms. Much brighter, drier, sunnier days for the second half of the week. It doesn't spring way back up in terms of temperature. It takes a couple of days to get there, but certainly should be some summery weather on the cards next week.